Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use Spline and Framer to build a 3D website like this with these glass spheres. So you can click and rotate and see different point of view for this scene. We will go and create a scene like this from scratch using the glass layer and the materials on the spline. And then we will learn how we can export this and insert this into Framer so we can build a responsive website like the one that you can see here. All right, let's begin. All right, so the first step is to create the spheres. So I'm just going to remove this rectangle by pressing delete, and then I'm going to click here on the top to start creating my sphere. So I'm going to click and drag by holding shift, and this sphere is going to be, I think, right there in the middle. And then I'm just going to press command, and I'm going to click and drag on the sphere to duplicate. So I want another one here, and I'm going to press shift and option to make it bigger, and then I'm going to put it here, and I'm just going to make a couple of more copies. Maybe one in here, maybe a smaller, maybe another one here, maybe another one here, and finally I think another one in here. All right, so I also want to change the color of my background to be something slightly bluish and gray. Let's say, I think I have this color already, so this is gonna be my background. All right, so I know that I want three main materials. One is the blue for the main color, and then we had the glass material, and then we had another material, but it's more like white color, right? So I'm going to create the material spheres. So this is going to be blue, this is going to be white, and this is going to be, I think, the glass. All right, so I'm going to assign the blue to this, and then to this one here, and then I'm going to just change this a little bit to be like this. Then I'm going to assign it to this, and then this. So I'm just going to reduce here a little bit the opacity, and I'm going to use overlay. And perhaps this is going to be a little bit more like this. And I also want to use Fresnel in here, something like 60%. All right, so for the blue, I want to change it to something that looks a little more bluish, something like this. And I also want to use overlay, so I need to adjust here a little bit so it compensates the saturation. Now I just want to move this sphere a little to the middle, and this one, so I want to move it a little to the front, and this one's here, I want to move it to the back. Okay, for the glass material, which is the ones for these two spheres, I'm going to assign the material, and then let's create a new layer here, and this is going to be a glass layer. So the values for the glass is going to be 100 in blur, 255 in thickness, and 1.08 in the refraction index. I also want to switch to perspective so we have a better idea of what is going on. I want to move this a little closer between each other, like this. So it's already starting to look really nice. As you can see here, the glass is almost disappearing here, right? So what I want to do is I want to create another layer, and this is going to be a Fresnel layer. And instead of being white, it's going to be more like black. And we're going to use an overlay here. And for the opacity, I think this is going to be like 50%. So it kind of give these spheres a little more volume because we can see now the edges. I also want to move my light to be in minus, I think something like minus 10. So it's kind of like right on the edge. And I want to create another light. It's going to be a point light. And I'm going to put it somewhere around here, maybe a little bit here, something like that. And for this, I'm going to disable the shadows because we don't really need the shadows there. And we are also going to enable soft shadows, so the main light has a soft shadow. And then we can increase the penumbra here to be higher, something like that. So I think this is already looking pretty cool. I want the glass to feel a little bit more complete. So I'm going to duplicate the glass layer by pressing the right click and pressing duplicate here. And this layer is gonna have an opacity of 20%. And the only difference here is that instead of 100 for the blurriness here, it's gonna be 25. So you can see here, what I'm doing is I'm mixing these two layers, and it feels like it has a little gradient happening in the blurring part. Now, another thing that I'm missing is that I want to have like a little more like bouncing light coming from this color to the glass. This is just for aesthetic reasons. I feel like it's gonna feel a little more interesting. So I'm just going to create here depth layer, and this depth layer is gonna be a blue color here, something like this. Then I'm going to copy this color, I'm going to paste it here, and then I'm going to reduce opacity right there. Now, right now I am working on local, but I'm going to change now to the world position. So now I'm going to move this like a gradient to be a little more like this, and I'm going to increase the radius. Yeah, it's already looking quite interesting, but what I want is I want to enable the smooth interpolation, so you can see right on the edges it feels a lot better. So let me switch that again so you can see the difference. Now I want to duplicate this again, and this time I want this to be in a local position, which means that it's gonna look the same for both of these spheres because it's in local position. I want this to be more like on the bottom part here, something like this. I also want this to be maybe something like 50% instead. It's gonna be very, very subtle right there. So now if we reset our camera, you can press Option R to reset the camera like this. And we can see more or less how everything is looking, right? So this sphere here is not looking good. So I want this sphere actually to be smaller and maybe be more like almost like inside this object in here, something like this. And this one to be a little bigger, so it's almost like catching some shadows in there. And perhaps the color for this could be also a little different, maybe a little more bluish, something like that, and a little darker, something like that. All right, so it seems like this is looking pretty good already. So now what I want is I want to move this into Framer, and then I want to integrate what I have here with my design inside Framer. In order to move this design into Framer, I just need to export this from Spline. So let me start by just changing the name to this document for something that makes more sense. So this is gonna be more like Glass Spheres Tutorial. And now I'm just going to enter in the export settings in here. And the moment I do this, it already export this scene. And if you click here, you can open this URL and you can see how it goes. So I'm just gonna do that and just to show you how it is. So this is how it looks in the export. So you can see actually this sphere is kind of like inside this other, so we need to fix that. So I'm just going to go back here quickly and adjust the position of this sphere so it's not inside this other one. Let me just reset my camera again. So go back to the export settings, and so a couple of things that I want to do here, right? So the first thing is I want to remove the logo because otherwise it will be interfering with my design, and I also want to disable panning, so I don't want this to be panning, and also I want to disable zooming. So for now this is all I want to do, and then I'm just going to click here in update, so it's going to update the link to my scene. So now I want to move my design into Framer, right? So I'm going to copy this, and now I'm going to go to Framer, and here inside Framer I already have a UI design for my website, right? I have three different sizes for desktop, tablet, and then the smaller sizes for phones. And here I have just a couple of items for my text and a button. So it's all very simple. And you can see here, what I'm doing is that I have a column here that is containing this other frame here that is basically a couple of items in here. So I have the text and the button in one side, and then on the other side I have my embed, right? In the embed is where I want to place my spline design. So this embed is something that you can add by pressing insert, and then you can go here and just type embed. You can already see this is the embed component. So if you click on the embed here in the settings, you can see that there is this URL parameter. So right here is where I can type the public URL that I generated inside Spline. So I'm just going to paste the link, and then I'm going to press return or enter to see how this changes here in the Framer app. You can see that already looks like something. So I can see my spheres right now and they look pretty nice, but kind of looks like crop, right? So it's right now it's being cropped here. And also it kind of feels like it's a little bit to the side. So one thing I want to do is I want to change the width of this to be maybe something like this. And I also want to avoid this cropping to happen here. So one idea is that I can just select my columns container, in this case, this one here. And then here you can see where it says overflow in the styles. You can see this says overflow hidden. So you can change this to be visible. And now if you click on the embed, you can see that even if it is upside this, it's not going to be cropped. So for here in the tablet size, you can adjust the positions a little bit as well, just to make sure that it looks a little better. Something like this, I think, much better what we have. And here, finally, we can also change things a little bit just to make it more interesting. Now, sometimes what you see here, it doesn't change properly because of the way the framer works with the iframes and the embeds. So you always need to check how this looks in your final export from Framer. So for now, I'm just gonna leave it like that, and then we can see in the actual production link how does that feel. So if you go here to the play mode in Framer, you can feel how this is inside Framer. You can click and drag, and this is how it looks. So it actually looks kind of nice. But one thing that I'm missing here is I kind of want this to move like when I'm hovering. So I'm going to go back to my scene here on Spline, and one thing that I want to enable is the rotation on hover. So this is going to be something like this, and I go to a play mode here on the Spline and you can see how it feels. So I think this is actually better because it kind of feels more interesting. And now I'm just going to update this so we can see the same changes on Framer. So now you can see here my changes on Framer, and it looks very nice. So I'm really liking this behavior already. All right, now let's see how this looks on the different sizes. So if you press here in the publish button, you can update your URL from Framer, and it's gonna give you this link. And then if you open that link, it's gonna show you the site right there from Framer, right? So one thing that I noticed is that perhaps everything could be a little bigger. Like maybe we can increase a little bit the zoom in here, and then we can export again. And that's gonna feel a little better. Reload and let's see how that feels. Yeah, I think that looks a little better. One thing I don't like is that there is a lot of space between these two. So maybe one thing that we can do is that we can go back to Framer here. And I think the maximum size that we have here is like 1300. Maybe let's put something like maybe like 150, something like that. And so the maximum is going to be 150, but we also need to make sure that we do it here as well. So for this component, it's going to be like 1150, and then we can update here. Now we're ready, we go back here. Yeah, that definitely feels a lot better for me. So yeah, this is how you can build your 3D design on a Spline, and then you can easily integrate this inside Framer by using the public URL that you generate. All right, that seems to be looking pretty fine. So I hope you like this tutorial. Please let us know in the comments if you want us to make more video tutorials like this one. All right, see you in the next one. Bye bye.